today we have an awesome Halloween haul for you guys. Some of this we got online and it's new for this year, 2018, and some of it our friend gave us for our anniversary. She's an awesome friend and I was practically near to tears with this package, and I'm never really near to tears unless I'm very heartbroken or enraged to the point that, like, you know how you're mad and you can't really do anything about the thing you're mad about? I can cry sometimes about that. Like, it's like an outlet for the rage, but I never usually cry for happiness, but I was just almost there with this awesome package. So wonderful. You guys will see why. Let's start with one of the things from our friend Karen from Yankee Candle. This is the most perfect, beautiful, wonderful thing Yankee Candle has ever created, you guys. And we did review a few, goodness, that was tricky to say, a new tongue twister, Yankee Candle products before, and I like them, but this is like the best thing they've ever made. It's like a heavy, I guess it's like a resin or something, but it seems very sturdy because it's got a very good weight to it. I know they use terracotta sometimes too, so I'm not sure, but it's us. It's everything that is us in one candle holder, you guys. It's like for votives, and you can do like LED candles, which we have some. It's so cool because she sent those too, but check this out. It's a raven in a top hat, and the top hat is like steampunky with like cogs and gears. How awesome is that? And ravens are totally us because Gomez and I go under Hugin and Munin for our little pen names. And it's a pumpkin, which is so like everything spooky and delightful. And the pumpkin has an owl on the front, which has like cogs and stuff on him, like his little beak. And he's got like eyes that are, it's all steampunky and magnificent and cool. So it's like everything gothic and Halloween and steampunk rolled into one. And Yankee Candle is just amazing for making this thing happen. Like, it's just the coolest thing ever, and it's only July, and it's like my favorite Halloween thing, I think, thus far, just for all year, and we're gonna keep it out all year. It's amazing, it's wonderful. You guys should check it out and get one from Yankee Candle. It's wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. And then here's how it's going to look with a little candle inside. Flop. Lovely, lovely. We're linking our other Halloween hauls below. If you guys are new, do subscribe, check out, hang out with us. And we have Halloween hauls from this year, last year, the year before, but a lot of stores will restock, or a lot of the things you can get online, so if you like some of our stuff, it's not like you can't find it still, so definitely check those out if you need some Halloween vibes while we're waiting for the Halloweenness. I am Morticia, this is Gomez, our roommate Slappy, and this wonderfulest candle in the world from Karen, and we're gonna do next our shoulder buddies from Halloween Asylum that we ordered, and then we're gonna go back to some more other Halloween stuff from Karen, but check this out. This is my pumpkin shoulder buddy. He's a little pumpkin creature. This is how he sits on the shoulder, and Gomez's little devil. We're gonna take them off and review them and show you how they actually like work and everything, but that's just how they're gonna look on. It's fun for an accessory just like to go around and just take your little friend with you, your little shoulder buddy, or if it's like Halloween and you want it to augment your costume, or if it's Halloween and you're one of those people that don't feel comfortable dressing up, or you're going somewhere that you can't dress up but you still wanna take a little spooky accessory, shoulder buddies are perfect. So I did a DIY bat shoulder buddy that I can also link below to show you guys a cool way to make your own. I'm going to DIY some rats after seeing how these were made as well. But these we bought, and this is like a little pumpkin creature, and he's got like little legs in the back. He's like a pumpkin creature, a monster. I love it. And then I love Gomez's little devil and his details. We're going to show you those close up as well. So let me undevil you. They have little angels on the same site and some other sites, so you can have like a devil on one shoulder, an angel on the other or something, but we just got the devil because, you know. Look how cute. They called it latex on the site that these are made out of. They're hollow, lightweight, comfortable, sturdy. I was afraid it would be like balloons or like those weird rubber gloves, but it doesn't feel like that. It's just like a kind of hollow rubber. And it feels fine, and they're very lightweight and comfortable. We were walking around in Walmart and had them on, and we didn't even feel them. What do you think, Gomez? Comfortable? Good?
Yes, and such an adorable smile he has.
Yes, he's so friendly and just, like, adorable. He seems like he'd be a blast to hang out with.
And cute little black horns.
And little pointed ears.
Yeah.
Ears. And then in the back, he has a tail. He has, like, four fingers on each hand on the front, and the back, he has, like, little cloven hoof things. And we were all like spooky at Walmart, and we met this cool chick that's husband like decorates and does like all out for Halloween, so we gave him our channel card, and they seem really cool. It's nice to meet people while you're out, you know, that comment in nice ways about how you're dressed and stuff when you're kind of different, so that's cool. We also met the other sorts in the line while we were paying that said, you know, Halloween was last year, and I just kind of ignored them like they didn't talk, because I would have said, actually, idiot, Halloween's every year, and for us, Halloween's every day, and why are you talking? But anyway, okay. I just think, I don't know why people make comments to people, because it's like, I'm not asking you to comment. So why are you commenting, like, in person to me in my face? Like, why? And also, like, I'm not commenting that your outfit's boring, so... And they would. They would think it was rude if we just came up and went, you know, you really need to accessorize more. You're looking so boring. It's like, ugh. I'm sorry, that was just a minor rant, but I had to say it. Because when people just come up and say stuff, they just don't stop to think that you know, they wouldn't like it if you were doing it to them. Like, so the way this works, this is very sturdy. This is an awesomely sturdy product because I wasn't really sure how the clip worked, and I practically almost, not exactly, I mean, I could have broken it if it had not been made really well. And I'm usually careful, but I had no idea, and the card that it came on was like telling you sort of how it worked, but not really, like, you know, those lovely instructions that don't really help. But anyway, it's made very sturdy, and it's a good clip. It doesn't hold a chunk of your clothes, but that's okay. What it does hold, it holds. So it's like inside, and you just squeeze it, like, it has, like, this is a flexible shoulder buddy, so that's good, because you just have to squeeze him like this, get the clip on, he's clipped, and then he just goes back to his regular little shape. So it's a very firm clip. I just hurt my finger on it to show you how firm it was.
Oh.
It will pinch the clothing tightly. It will not come off. You can bend. You can stretch. You can jump. You can chase zombies if you need to, and it will not come off. And so, yeah, and the pumpkin works the same way, but I'm going to take him off so you can see him from behind and everywhere up close. I love the little stem on top. He's a cute little wicked pumpkin, and I like the fact that he's like a pumpkin creature with the arms and legs instead of just a pumpkin. That's cute. I love Gomez's little devil's tail and his little wings. He's so cute. I can't remember who it was, but I recently saw somebody reviewing an action figure. It was like a demon or a monster, and they said it was sexy. And I was like, that's so something we would say. Like, this is what we consider beautiful. Yes.
Yes.
He's adorable.
He is.
Look at his little beard.
Yes, goatee of love.
Now this, these were like $11 each from Halloween Asylum. Other sites have them for like $20, and they're cool and cute, but I don't think they're worth $20, so I would go Halloween Asylum, which we will link below, of course. And these are about probably 8 or 9 inches long by 4 wide by 3 tall. I'm just approximating, could be 4, but yeah, a general like size gauge for you, so. Yeah, they're sturdy, durable, flexible, lightweight, comfortable. I mean, like, everything you could want. Lovely. And I love the clips, and it gives me ideas on how to DIY a rat clip. They had these Dollar Tree ravens for the past couple years. It's like a kind of 3D little raven figure on a clip, and those make good shoulder buddies, too. They're like a hard plastic. So those are cool. Next, another awesome from our friend Karen. It's Halloweeny. It's Bela Lugosi as Dracula, and he is from Creepy Co., which we got some basil, like, bag clips and unboxed earlier in the year in our Halloween playlist. So I like them. They make nice quality products. The pin stays on well. It's got good grips. And it's him from the neck up. He even got the little cape with the collar going up to symbolize, like, little bat ears. It's so adorable. And I like the fact that it's specifically Bela Lugosi, like, not just a generic Dracula. And so, you know, it's like, it's just, it brings back the iconicness. That's my favorite, one of my favorite Renfields is in this movie, so. Bela Lugosi's dead. And then it's got the two pinbacks on the back, so it's nice and sturdy. It's going to stay on well, and it's lovely. And this is one reason I was, like, so almost in tears, is just everything she sent us was so wonderful and amazing. But also, Freddy and Dracula are in this book series we're writing, and it was just so close to my heart that we got both of them in pins. We can share these, so it's awesome too. Like, it's just beautiful. And it's Freddy. He's a good, beautiful enamel Freddy with his fedora and his glove. And look, the glove is like on a spring, so it's like motion glove action. Freddy is my hero. I wrote a paper about Freddy Krueger being my hero in fifth grade when we had to do an essay on who our hero was. And it didn't get much comment from the teacher, to her credit. Like, I mean, you know, she didn't want my mom to, like, send me to a shrink or anything, so that was kind of cool. I was like, you know, he's my hero because he can do whatever he wants in dreams, and, like, he'll get you. So, like, yeah, that was cool. And the last item we're both wearing, you can see Gomez's while I take mine off. It's a lovely raven enamel from our awesome friend Karen. Thank you.
Thank you, Karen.
These are like so wonderful for our anniversary because they're us. We're the two ravens, and I just wanted to cry. I keep thinking I need a raven brooch, and I've never gotten around to finding one I liked, and I love these. These are the enamel ones with a nice sturdy clutch back, and it's got its beak open cawing, which like is like mine and Gomez's thing. That's like our caw. We'll do it to each other sometimes, or the ravens outside follow him until he answers them. They'll scream at him until he actually answers them. They know him because he has a really good raven. I don't. I'm just like, I'll say caw, but he really sounds like a raven. And he'll there you go. And they'll follow him, and they get really mad if he doesn't, like, answer them. So
my hair is also black like their feathers. So
yeah, but when you're wearing your black bat hat, they still know you, and they know you in a different hat, and they know you without a hat. They know you. Really cool. So like, yeah, our friend Jess, if you're watching this, Jess, caw. She's another raven friend, so we'll use that as our like greeting sometimes to each other, like, so yeah. Anyway, this is I'm not sure where the raven and the Freddy came from, so if our friend comments and tells us in the comments, or if she tells me in an email, I'll tell you or whatever, but I know that the Bela Lugosi was from Creepy Co because he's on a Creepy Co card. That's indicative. So I figured it out all by myself. So yeah, and today, July 12th, is Gomez's anniversary for being in the U.S. for 14 years. He came when he was just a little baby. Well, he didn't get here as a baby, but he was a young, fresh-faced child. And he's grown up into a fine young gentleman, still with the sexy Russian accent. He did not lose it like so many when they immigrate and change and lose the beautiful accent. So thank you for still staying hot and not becoming too Americanized. Just for me, right?
Yes.
So tomorrow's our wedding anniversary, but today is the day he like originally came to US, so that's really cool. And so we celebrate like both days, one after the other. It's always fun. So this was so fun to get a package. And our friend sent us some other stuff, but we're going to review it in a witchy haul because I have some other witchy things and they're like witchily inclined, so I get to split it up. But we hope you enjoyed this Halloween haul. And until next time,
stay spooky, my friends.